Lee County is looking at easing traffic at a half dozen intersections with these roundabouts. Whether you love them or hate driving in them, experts say they make the roads safer.
But tonight, NBC2 investigator David Hodges uncovers problems with the way some of our roundabouts were designed. He joins us live in the newsroom.
Peter and Kelly, not all roundabouts are created equal. We found that while they make roads much, much safer, they're not always done right, and that can give them a bad reputation.
They're confusing.
Kind of nightmarish.
Different.
There's always going to be a conflict. Somebody's always going to have to wait.
And new to America, even newer to Florida.
I got called a roundabout salesman in a sort of negative sense.
Michael Wallwork has been selling and designing roundabouts since moving from Australia for one main reason.
Because of the safety benefits of them.
Over 90% reduction in fatalities, yes, right, compared to signals and stop controlled.
I mean, is there anything else that you could expect that kind of return of in this job?
No, no.
Bill Hadaway is District 1 Secretary for the Florida Department of Transportation. He's been tasked with making Florida roads safer. One tool he's chosen is the roundabout.
When I came back 4.5 years ago, we had 7 on the state system. Since we put our new guidance in place, which requires modern roundabouts to be evaluated before you can put a signal in, we've doubled that number in less than 3 years.
But not all roundabouts are created equally. Some, like this one in Naples, have design flaws that cause serious problems.
I think the biggest challenge is just education of our own staff and the professionals that work with us. They're not used to designing roundabouts.
My theory is if you can't do a good roundabout, don't do it.
Wallwork helped us identify roundabouts in Southwest Florida that are causing more problems than solutions. Here's one of the worst, the roundabout at the Coconut Point Mall. The other trouble one is at Via Coconut Point. Wallwork says these are poorly designed because the turns are too wide and don't force drivers to slow down, making crashes more likely. Roundabouts also don't work when the traffic volume is too high and in congested downtown areas. But Wallwork will keep pushing for roundabouts over signal intersections.
Why are you a roundabout salesman?
Because I've been T-boned twice at signalized intersections. My sister got hit by a lady running a red light. I had a girlfriend killed because a driver ran a red light. So, yeah, I'm a roundabout salesman because I've saved a lot of people's lives and a lot of people from injury and damage to their vehicles by promoting roundabouts as much as I can.
The Florida Department of Transportation is working on improving roundabout designs by holding seminars with engineers. If you want to learn more about why roundabouts are now favored in Florida and which ones weren't done the right way, go to our website, nbc-2.com. Live in the newsroom, David Hodges, NBC2.